I'm just a man. Help me believe in what I could be and all that I am. Show me the stairway.
Wanting the real. mountain de reso mulo così. Yesu wange, echiti woche, ochin pote, momo yo we, o, motoko vo, yenazako, e, bibi yake, di musiko.
Oh,
sai gue. Pastor Jamada Nava de la Mueva de Nyoktuka.
Obulambo bange kunsinange wimbi kwaliwa. Imisana ne chironga vikomi. Kekasela komu wendo no mutisa kwa Yesu.
Sabbath morning first, whom you have called from this life, may be brought by you to the blessing.
Let us now there to find meaning of our
bread your salad among us, for whom we celebrate this Eucharist, a share in your chosen ones, in the blessedness you give, so that on the day of resurrection, free from the bonds of mortality, you may come before your face. This is our prayer for our Lord Jesus Christ, his Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
We
are the presence of God. And when Paul writes to the Romans and reminds us that we belong to the Lord, then we know that we are not lost, even in the moment of death. The departure of body arouses many questions in us. And also departing in that way, going to be seen and being found lifeless in a swamp. That leaves many questions, and I don't have any answer. But there is one who has an answer, who in a way saw all of us taking place. He never wanted to intervene into the freedom of human beings, but he has been questioned for whoever is in a way responsible for the anti-martial of God. This is the way not to threaten anyone, but it's also a question that St. Paul poses in the letter to the Romans we have had. Why do you despise your brother or your sister to the extent of facilitating his moral departure from life? That question will be answered by those of us who know. For us, who are now in the cloud of unknowing, yet our knowledge is not based on any research, but on our faith in God, who never deserts us, even in the time of suffering and difficulty. We are here, and we may seem to be in front of a disaster, but it is not a disaster in the eyes of God. It would be of only the eyes of the foolish. And I would dare to say, the foolish will be those who are godless in their lives, who have no respect for human life, and who are quick to rejoice when there is death, and act as agents of death. We are on the side of God. God is on our side. God is the God of life. And that's why we come here to thank Him for the precious gift of the life of God. He entrusted him to us as a gift. He was a blessing. And all of you who have known Boniface will attest to his goodness. The siblings and the parents will be witnesses of that. What he has been and who he remains to be in their lives. A young man discovered the mystery of life, of trusting God. And this is the witness of one of the siblings, that he prayed for it. It is not to be taken for granted that young people, especially their youth, find access to prayer to God only when they are rooted and they know that their life is in the hands of God. So this is now a moment for us to always also remain faithful so that we may put our trust in this challenging moment in God. God, who is grace and mercy, who accepts the life of Boniface as a gift. He has been snatched away from our knees, but we believe that he is back with his Creator. What does this departure do to us? It troubles our hearts. It gives us questions. Jesus tells us today, it seems to be a contradiction. Do not let your hearts be troubled. But I will say realistically, because knowing the pain of what Martina and Vena and the siblings of Bonnie are going through, that yes, your hearts are troubled. You have many questions. But I point you to two signs. The cross in our midst. That cross is the answer to the many unanswered questions of life. God seems to be silent, but wants us to look at the cross. Where you don't find any answer, look at the cross. He allowed and he let his son die for sinners so that they are not condemned, but they are given the way out of darkness. The departure of Boniface casts darkness over the family and over us all, also the parish community, because this is the place where Boniface grew up, going to our kindergarten and way to Africa, going to our schools and physical. This is where he received his sacraments. We are bidding farewell to him, to our own, and we feel the darkness that his departure casts over our community. But we have the light that will never be destroyed, the light of the risen Christ. This is the Easter candle as the second symbol to orient us also as we mourn, as we continue asking questions, as we go meditating on the mystery of life, that whatever darkness we go through, it is not true that we are enlightened by the light of Christ. This is what I wish, that this light of the risen Lord may shine in your family that you have better. That the gap, the departure of Boniface creates in your heart may be filled by the presence of Christ. And since we can't do that, we can't reverse the course of things, we just put ourselves into the hands of God and then declare our readiness to be with God, to be on the side of God. And that those who are in a way that are tempted to help the people to carry out destruction, may they also be touched, that they may consider the pain that is inflicted to those who have mourned the death of a young person like this. And as we journey on, young and old, let us ask always ourselves, do you really know where you are going? That is the question of Thomas when he said, but we don't know where you are going, and yet he himself is the way. We look at Christ, he's going ahead of us, he put death to death, and when he comes again, he opened for us a new perspective. There we hope in the dwelling place he has prepared for us. We hope for joy, and this joy we wish on us. There we never miss again, because it's at the source of life in the bosom of his Creator. The Lord is with you. Let us rise and offer prayer and petition. We call trusting in upon God, the Holy Father, who raised Christ his Son from the dead for the salvation of the living and the dead. Is our brother God who has received in his baptism the seed of eternal life. May he enjoy the gathering of the saints forever. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
This our brother Boniface was nourished by Christ's body, the bread of eternal life. May he now be the welcome guest at that name that has been prepared by the good shepherd. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
The departure of Boniface leaves a big gap in the life of his loved ones. May Christ, the risen Lord, be their consolation and surround them in his own presence. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
Let us pray for all families that are afflicted in one way or another, especially those who are looking for their heroes. That the Lord, with his light, the light of his truth, may bring about that what they cannot bring about and restore dignity of life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
Let us pray for all those who journey with Christ in his life and are now resting in his peace, that they may be partakers of the life of the resurrection. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
Let us pray for ourselves who are come here today to pray in the spirit of faith, that casting our eyes Jesus Christ, we may not lose our way, but may be rooted in him who is the source of our life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
In a moment of silence, let us wish one of us that
Thank you.
Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Peace and unity and God is with you all, putting my reign forever and ever.
Amen.
the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen. Almighty God, that your servant Boniface, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
It is our solemn duty to carry out the traditional manner of God's faithful people, the burial of his mortal body. We do this consciously, that the body of Boniface, when he was baptized, became God's temple, deserving all dignity and respect. We trust God, from whom all creation comes, has life, that in his due time we bring to resurrection with all the saints the body of this our brother Boniface, which in his frailty shall be buried. May God unite his soul with those of all the saints and the faithful departed. May he be given a merciful judgment, so that redeemed from death, freed from punishment, reconciled to the Father, carried of the Good Shepherd, he may deserve to enter fully into everlasting happiness in the company of the eternal King, together with all the saints. All merciful Father, we commend the soul of this our brother into your hands. We are strengthened by the sure hope that he, together with all who have died in Christ, will rise again with Christ on the last day. We thank you for all the blessings with which you endowed this servant of yours in his life here on earth. They are for us a token of your love and of the blessed union of the saints in Christ. Listen then, Lord, in your mercy to our prayers, that the gates of paradise may be opened to your servant, and that we who are left on the pilgrimage of life here on earth may console one another with words of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our brother Boniface forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. May the Spirit of the
Lord, come down.
May the Spirit of the Lord come down.
May the Spirit of the Lord come down.
Bless me, pray. May the Spirit of the Lord.
from you. And where Lazarus is poor no longer, there be you have eternal rest.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord,
and let your perpetual rest upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord,
and let your perpetual rest upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless and protect you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Let us stay with the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
And He remained in the church ever since, as you heard from the celebrant. Boniface was a very religious person. He did not miss prayers. Even on the day that his kidnappers trapped him, he had just returned from church on Sunday. His life was very short, but very peaceful. Those of you who know Benny Boniface very well, he was a calm person, very obedient, very loving, very kind. You can use any word to describe Boniface, but he was a kind person. If you look at that book, everyone who talks about Boniface, you'll see the key word, calm, obedient, kind. And if I may just take one word from the sister, one of the Boniface sibling, Hope, on page 15, how he describes his brother. Was a loving sibling, gentle,
calm, hardworking, sincere, and kind. Basically, it was a full package of a good heart and a person. This is the summary that his sister gave him, and that is what we know about Boniface. What led to the death of Boniface? I'll just give you a very brief story, and then you can conclude. On Sunday 13th of this month, when after returning from church at 5 p.m., Boniface went home, and while he was home, he received a phone call from someone that all of us don't know, but was known to him. And he walked out of the house to go and respond to that call, and unfortunately, he never returned when he received that phone call. From those who know him, and when they saw him coming towards the border stage, where he usually picks his motorcycle to go to town, on that day Boniface did not do as always he does. He comes, sits on the border, and takes him. He never takes anybody that is just passing by. He picks a border from that stage. But on that Sunday evening, it was the contrary. He seemed very much in a hurry, and when his colleagues, the border that know him, wanted to give him a lift, he apparently told them no, because he was going to, apparently, the people who were waiting for him in some car that was parked nearby. So Boniface went. Unfortunately, how he entered that vehicle, we still don't know. And where they went after that, we also don't know. It was therefore in the morning on Monday that the parents started getting concerned, because they thought actually Boniface had left office. By the time of his death, Boniface was doing internship with the Tata Uganda. And he had concluded that internship on Saturday, 12th. He was supposed to return to the university to start examination on Monday, the 14th. And between that Saturday and the 14th, that kidnapping happened, and we never saw Boniface again. So that Monday, he was supposed to be in examination, his final examination of the year, of the whole four-year course, until his colleagues who were sitting the same examination with him noticed that he was missing in the examination room. And then they called the mother and said, look, where is Boniface? We are not seeing him in the exam room. And that is when the mother started putting ABC together and also realized that, look, actually Boniface left all his belongings at home. He didn't carry them, because they also thought on that Sunday evening Boniface had gone back to the university, because on Monday he was supposed to start examination. So Monday passed, Boniface was nowhere to be seen. Tuesday, he was nowhere to be seen until about late in the afternoon on Tuesday, when social media started coming up with a recovered body of someone who was found dead and floating on Lake Victoria at Port Bell. That's when the parents started seeing the pictures, and we immediately put ourselves together to start following up with the police and to find where his body was taken. When we reached the police, we were told that the body was recovered on Monday morning off the shore of Lake Victoria at Port Bell in Luzira, and his body was taken to the KCCS City Mortuary, where we went and indeed confirmed that that was our son Boniface. We, at the moment, cannot tell what exactly happened. Who the kidnappers were, we cannot tell. We have left the issue is with the police. They are investigating, and we pray that the police should do due diligence so that the kidnappers, the killers of Boniface, are brought to book and face the law. Common sense will definitely tell you when you are kidnapped, you go through so many tortures. And while we wait for the postmortem report, which we still don't have within our hands, it is obvious that the kidnappers of Boniface killed him by violent means. And they disguised the death by throwing his body somewhere in the water so that we cannot find what happened. But someone knows what happened, and that is God. God knows what happened, and as a family, we are not going to revenge the death of Boniface. We pray, and we should pray, for the killers to be found so that they repent, so that they stop killing innocent Ugandans. This has been our prayers, and this has been our message. You will also hear from Boniface's father. He will revenge. His soul will speak for him, and his blood in their hands will bring them forward. So briefly, dear mourners, that is as short the life history of our son and brother Boniface. We therefore pray that the Lord God receive him amongst his good people. At this moment, let me take this time to introduce the family of Boniface, Mr. Bernard Olwoch, and the wife, Mrs. Martina Kimera Olwoch. Could you please stand up? These are the parents of Boniface. Mr. Olwoch works with the Mako General Motors in Gulu. He has been a long-time staff of Komboni Missionaries, and ever since he retired from there, he got a small assignment with this motoring company. And Mama works with Bishop Cipriano Kiangire. She has been there for since I don't know when. But these are the parents of Boniface. Please, may you also come here now and say something briefly. Then we will lay the wreath, and then we will walk out so that we can catch up with time. While the parents are coming, please, the children also come over here so that we all stand together. The children, Hope and Paul, the rest, please come. The parent will only greet you. Just thank you for standing with us. Please come over. Come over. Come over. Thank you.
The Lord is good, and all the time. Yeah, we need to thank Him, even when we are grieving. We need to thank Him because we have seen another day. I also thank all of you here present for supporting us. I thank the management of Tata Uganda Limited, the management and staff of Bishop Cipriano Kiangire, management and staff of Marco General Motors, Kiambogo University. Dear friends, in a special way, I would also like to thank the family of General Okello, who has stood with us all this time. Boniface, I call him in different names. I call him Boni, Bonini, Boniface, and Olara. All these names have got meaning to me. Boni was like a father to me. I don't really have much to talk about Boniface. Everyone has spoken. But there's one thing that I would like to you mourners know about Boniface. He was a liberator to us. He was peace loving. He was a unifier. Boniface was someone, if there is problem in our family, when he comes and stands and we look at his face, immediately that issue is settled. I will miss him. May the Almighty God rest his soul in eternal peace. Thank you very much.
The Lord is good, and all the time. We have nothing to say much. You've heard all. I want to thank you all, and it is well. We can't reverse. We have accepted. God gives and takes. I felt very empty, no life in me. Sunday at around 11 to midnight, I didn't know what was happening. I never slept. I used to get up early and leave home at 6, but I delayed up to 7. And mostly I attend Mass at 7. That morning I didn't. I didn't know what was happening. I reached at school. I went in the adoration room. I knelt. I said, Lord, I don't know what is happening. I called him. He didn't pick. He's not returning the call. I told the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament, let me know what is happening. It has never happened to him. Never. He has been in the village. He could go far, but when he gets my call, he could tell me, Mommy, I was traveling. I went to Kasese, I went to Mbarara. I was driving, that's why I didn't pick, but I'm coming back at the time. Morning of Monday, there was nothing. And when I spoke to the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament, let me know something. And that is when I came to know, no life, what I felt that night. And it's well. When he has done something wrong, please forgive him. And when he has borrowed something, we paid the debt we shall pay. But it's well. We have confidence because you are here with us. Continue praying for us so that we journey well. Internal rest grant to him, O Lord.
Amen.
May he rest in peace.
Amen.
Dear mourners, please, let's be strong. Let us be strong. When you cry, then how do you expect us, the parents, the children, to react? So let's be calm, let's be strong, so that we can conclude this Mass with confidence and with strength. We still have a long journey to go, so we need all the strength that you brought for us this morning. So very briefly, this is the order of laying of the wreath. We are going to have the parents, followed by the brothers and sisters. Then we shall have the Kiambogo University representative, and then the representative from Bishop Sipiano, Tata Uganda. Then we shall have the aunties from both sides of Boniface relations, and then we shall have the first cousins of Boniface. Then we will have the entire BCK family, only the representatives, to come and lay the wreath. And the power and automotive class of 2017, these are the students who were with Boniface in the same class, they will lay the wreath. And then PDI Tata, and then we shall have anyone who has a wreath to lay, will give you the opportunity, and then the final will be laid by the celebrants on the altar here. So very quickly, let me ask the parents of Boniface to come and lay the wreath. And after them would be the brothers and sisters together. The prayer has already been said, so just put your wreath. We don't now want you to again say lots of prayers. The prayer has already been said. Thank you very much. The brothers and sisters, please come up. Be strong and come on. Then after the brothers and sisters, representative.
So the order of marching out will be this way, like I've said.
The condolence basket will be in front where the portrait of Boniface is. You can come over there, please pay your last respect and then march out. The family members will be the last to march out together with the caskets. Sorry, we can't view the body now. We have to go. We do apologize that we cannot allow the viewing of the body now. So let's go proceed to the final, song, and then we do the basket. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Houston man. Help me believe in what I could be and all that I am. Show me the stairway.
Yesu wange Echiti woche Ochimpote Omoyo we O motokovo Yenazako E Bibi yake Imusiko
Yeah. fedidi kwango mama nika Yesu wali ko
Kulembe